One of the important research aspects of the landmark is understanding the grasslands. As part of our research program, we made the decision to restore the prairie here at the landmark, to bring it back to what it looked like in the 1880s.
And fire helps us do that because it helps us not only rejuvenate the native plants, but also get rid of the invasive species, the plants that shouldn't be here because they're not native to this environment.
It's an art and a science to be good at it. And we try to mimic what nature would have done.
For years, the theory was all fires needed to be extinguished. That philosophy is changing because now we understand more about the environment. We understand that fire is actually a tool that nature uses to rejuvenate an ecosystem.
Prescribed burning is based on a prescription, so there's a burn plan that's set up.
Weather is the key to a successful burn.
You're not also just looking at the weather of the day of the burn, but you're looking at the weather 24 hours from now. You got to contact your neighbors, smoke sensitive areas.
We discuss what our goals are for the day, what the plan is for the day.
And you're monitoring the weather throughout the burn, seeing how conditions change.
And so a few years back, during a burn school, I think, well, one of my crew members, well, he had brought this helium in a canister and some balloons, and I wish we'd have thought about that 30 years ago. But it really gives you an idea of surface winds and winds aloft.
Say we have new crew members. I'll try to work them in. I need y'all to scatter out in positions that I feel that they would be most utilized.
And everybody's role is very important. It's not just the fire boss. It's not just the guy that lights. It's also the suppression people. We all work together as one big team.
One of the things I'm looking at is herbaceous fuel moisture content, and which means in layman's terms, the moisture, amount of moisture that's in the grass. I knew that we didn't have very little of a green or water component to the fine fuels. Therefore, we were looking at trying to get out here earlier in the morning when we had a really high, relatively high relative humidity.
We're not just going to go light on the south end of this unit and send a head fire to the north end. We will strategically put in a black line on this north end, expecting a south wind later today. Then once we get this black line put in, then we've got a very safe buffer to run the major fire into so that it doesn't jump to adjacent properties.
Black lining is a technique used to burn out a specified area prior to a more aggressive, intense head fire.
You know, our goal today is to do the entire burn unit, which is around 200 acres. But if weather doesn't cooperate at all, then we won't do anything. But if it cooperates some and we can safely get the black line in today, then I would be pretty happy about that. Then we can shut down, make sure this is safe, and then pick a day in the future that the weather is perfect. And then all we have to do is basically light the bigger fire, and it will run in this area that we've already burned.
All of the native animals who lived here, their ancestors evolved with fire just like the plant communities did. So they have protective mechanisms that they use. And all of the animals have a much keener sense than some of us do about where the danger is and what to do to avoid it.
We've built a good relationship with the City of Lubbock Fire Department as well as the Texas Tech Fire Marshal's Office. By minimizing our fuel loads, maybe already having some of the areas around the landmark already burned out, that is certainly going to be a huge help to a wildfire if it were to encounter this area, because the fuel here has already been basically dealt with.
It also has allowed us to incorporate that aspect again into the research program and extend the knowledge that we've gained. We can go on to the ranches where we work and offer them assistance, and we have done that.
Having the head knowledge is one thing, putting everything into actual practice, they're two totally different components. This isn't something that you don't just go to a school, learn about it, and then the next day go and implement it. It takes some time to really learn that art.